it's the same for any industry. I think organizations need to create a climate which is more conducive for women in terms of the environment and the policies. Equally, I think the male managers, line managers need to ensure that they are more sensitive in terms of understanding women, not being biased or not being partial or not being their favorites, but making sure that they understand that women's needs are slightly different and they need to treat them more sensitively. More importantly, I think we have a role as a society where we need to break stereotypes and encourage our daughters, our sisters to really not be treated any different as the men in the house and the boys in the house, and that I think will really bring more women to the forefront.
Mindset changes at both ends, so for both women to believe that they can and for men to believe also that they can. A lot of times I feel that men are willing to take that jump, but women themselves are not sure. So I think, like I said inside, have conviction, believe in yourself, and just go for it, because whatever we normally land up doing, I mean, think we want to do, we'll end up doing that.
I don't really think we need to do anything different. We need to just start recognizing merit. And that alone, I believe, is enough, because women have the ability to shine through. As long as we can stop looking at gender and we're looking only at merit, we don't have to hold back at all.
You know, I've been very often asked this question about, is there parity, are women treated equally? Is there gender discrimination? In the industry that I belong to, I'm sure there is. But I have just one word of advice, something that I have always believed. It doesn't sound great, but it really is. My philosophy, amongst so many others that I have, like this too shall pass, has always been push. P-U-S-H, push. Very often, there are two things that we fail to do. One is we fail to dream. We fail to dream because we've already built so many walls around us. Like one of the esteemed speakers says, the glass ceiling is, it's translucent, it's transparent, and it can be broken through. I actually believe that. I believe that all you have to do is believe and probably work really hard at it. Yes, it may be, twice the amount of work, but it really is worth it. But the first important thing is to dream it, to be there. We're so scared to dream it because we believe your past references have shown that this doesn't work. Women don't belong here. A woman can't do that. A woman will never get that position. It really is not true. We've got to get our minds out of the gender circle, that we're a particular gender, because really capability, talent, and what you can do has no gender. I've been waking up the city on radio for the past 12 years. I don't think there's ever been a thing about like a male radio jockey or a female radio jockey. If you're good at what you do, just forge ahead, and I believe the universe and you yourself will help yourself. Okay, men folk, you gotta help us too.
I first of all think the media and the advertising industry is a lot more open to having women, and it's a lot more flexible and conducive for women to be a part of this industry. It's in fact advantageous to be a woman in this industry, and the industry is full of women. There may not be women at the senior levels and all, but I think overall as an industry, the industry does quite a bit to have women in it. And I for one feel really privileged and happy that I am part of this industry, and I feel it makes it easier to be in this industry and be a woman.